DJ Atomica here again with Transporter as we journey back to Horizon, Mexico, because there's a new Lamborghini in their game. Tell us about it, man.
This is the all-new Lamborghini Huracan Estil, the most track-focused V10-powered car Lamborghini has made since the record-setting Huracan Performante. The STO in the car's name stands for Super Trofeo Omologato, and that makes sense as this is basically an homologated road-going version of their Super Trofeo racing machine. It shares the same amount of power as the Performante, but is rear-wheel drive only, which might mean that it's not as quick to 60 miles per hour off the line, but is much lighter overall due to lightened materials used, and no extra torque split between the front and rear axles.
So with this season of Horizon Mexico being the high-performance season, and Playground Games bringing out all the high-performing road and track monsters, including this lovely thing, I reckon we could see some pretty good cars for online racing, right?
Definitely, this car included. In the past, when we received high-performance versions of certain supercars, they would perform worse than their original counterparts when set to specific classes like S1 class. Now, I think they've mended it, as this Huracan STO might be the best Huracan to date, even with the Performante, the Evo, and the standard car still in this game.
Is it a meta chaser, though? I think that's what everyone wants to know. Is this car good enough to take on the best of S1 class?
Well, kind of. This car puts down some immense grip and control, and with the right setup, you could surprise some racers driving those meta cars, but it's not an all-out king, unfortunately. It still drives really nice, though.
Then let's see what it can do. I'm eager to find out how it will place on your leaderboard, man.
It's pretty high up there. I'll give you that. I'll give you more details afterward.
This Lamborghini is really up there on your leaderboard, as you said. Another car up there that beats it is the Porsche 911 GT3992. How does that car edge out this Lamborghini?
Weight and power, it seems. There were some swaps involved when making both cars S1 class capable. For the Porsche, I swapped out the standard high-revving flat six for the twin-turbocharged one from the GT2 RS and gave it all-wheel drive. For the Lamborghini, I merely gave it all-wheel drive, which made it heavier. Both cars grip so well, but that Porsche is just so fast, albeit drifty.
And what was that you were testing mid-video? There was a tune by this I suck at driving user you were using. What did he do to the STO?
For some reason, of which I still don't understand, expert racers like him and others put rally tires on their cars so that they can have more room to increase a car's power so that it still sort of handles well, but is much faster in S1 class. It's something I'm not completely sure of, even with the game being this old. I mean, a lot of top racers have been using this technique, with most of them, I suck at driving included, being keyboard players with me racing on an Xbox controller. I, for one, prefer to have grip all the time as I simply need that control.
Skill issue?
Maybe. I don't play this game as much as they do. I'm more of a Need for Speed / The Crew 2 / Gran Turismo / Assetto Corsa / Drive Club kind of driver. Some arcade, more simulation.
I guess we can let it slide for now, but with these new cars coming this season, we're gonna see you in Horizon Mexico more, right?
I kinda have no choice now. With the Audi RS6 Avant and Porsche Mission R coming in a couple of weeks, I really can't miss out on what's going on in this update.
We'll hold you to that. The Lamborghini Huracan STO is just the start of a lot of high-performance love that Forza are delivering to us before we jump to Forza Motorsport later this year. Thanks to Transporter for his commentary and driving today. This is DJ Atomica telling it like it is on Transporter FM.